How do I turn off UAC, User Account Control, in Windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here with askleo.com, politely suggesting that you don't, but I will show you how. Let's get right to that after we read the question. I've tried living with user access control in Windows, but I've decided it's more annoyance than it's worth. I know what I'm doing, and I did just fine in old versions without UAC. How do I turn the darn thing off? You'll notice that it's called User Account Control, User Access Control. Windows' official term for it is User Account Control, but it's generally simply referred to as UAC. Okay, let's turn it off. This is Windows 11, but the process is very similar for Windows 10 and previous versions. I'm firing up the Settings app, and I'm simply going to search for UAC. Change User Account Control Settings, exactly what we want. Now you'll notice that there's a slider here that will allow you to adjust just how frequently or what kinds of things will trigger the UAC interruption. To turn it off, just slide it all the way to the bottom. Hit OK. Answer or confirm via what would probably be your last UAC response. And you're done. UAC has been turned off on this machine. So, what are the implications of doing so? The reason UAC is a good thing is that it at least warns you when something that is affecting the system is about to occur. I say it warns you because most of us are using UAC or administrator capable accounts, which means the UAC dialog box is just a yes, no, yes, I want to do this, or no, I don't. So it's warning you that something important is happening. A lot of the time, perhaps even most of the time for us, those important things are things that you and I are actually doing. We're installing some software, we're changing a setting, we're doing something that affects the system at a low level. The reason UAC is helpful is security. Because if you accidentally download and run malware, or if it gets onto your machine some other way, without UAC enabled, malware can do whatever the heck it wants at the lowest level of your operating system without you knowing a thing. If you've got UAC enabled, as I generally recommend you do, then when that malware tries to do something it shouldn't, you'll get a notice. You'll get the UAC dialog, and it'll tell you what program is trying to do something. If it's not something that you actually initiated yourself, then it's probably worth paying attention to before you click yes or no. But that's what UAC is all about. I get that the pop-up, the UAC confirmation dialog, can be a little annoying. I know that in older versions of Windows, it was perhaps too frequent. But today in Windows 10 and Windows 11, it's commonplace. And for the record, it's also very similar to macOS and Linux in the sense that the average user does need to at least confirm, if not supply additional credentials, in order to perform system affecting changes. But that's all it is. Now you know how to turn it off. And before I let you go, I'm going to show you how to turn it back on, because ultimately that's what I want you to do. The setting here, the default setting, notify me only when apps try to make changes to my computer, which is what we've been talking about, is exactly where you want it to be. This time, because UAC was not turned on, I was able to just hit OK to turn it on. I didn't need anybody's permission. Now, to make system level changes, I'll get the UAC prompt. Hope that was helpful. If you still need to turn off UAC, you now know how, but hopefully you also understand why you probably don't really want to. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3169. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.